One final password thing. I know I promised the last one was the final one, but we gotta mention this. We know how to store passwords securely on the server. We still have this issue that if you type in a password, remember how when we did the forums, I showed you that you could type in a password in a password text box, you know, and it looks like little circles or little asterisks. And that even when you submit this in the URL, you could still see, remember we saw Q equaled Hunter 2 before when we were playing around with that. Submitting a form, to go back to our trusty picture, you know, if you're submitting this password to these servers, the password is actually sent in clear text over the internet. So you're storing the password securely on your server. If your database gets stolen, you know, you're covered pretty much. But the problem is, when the user logs in, they're actually sending this password in clear of the internet. So if you really, really care about that, about having the password encrypted the whole way so some bad guy in the middle can't just, you know, sniff the password off the wire, you use HTTPS. And all HTTPS is it's like HTTP, except it's encrypted over SSL. That means this whole communication is encrypted, so this man in the middle, in theory, unless he's hacked VeriSign, and they'd never get hacked, can't see what's being transmitted over the wire. So it's all gobbledygook to him. So anyway, that's what HTTPS is for. And if you really are, if you're building something that's secure, you know, perhaps not a blog, but you know, Gmail, for example, you want to be using HTTPS. And then you've got secure transmission from the browser to the servers, and you've got secure passwords on the servers, and you're in a reasonably good setup.